Here is an outdoor HDR 360 photo captured with the new Dualfisheye RAW 9 bracketed photos from the Ricoh Theta Z1. You can see the hot sun and the shadow of the tree clearly. Here is the regular Theta Z1 photo of the same spot. You see the differences in dynamic range. If you watch my latest Theta Z1 review video, you know taking 9 bracketed photos take less than 1 second. But if you merge them internally in HDR, it takes about 45 seconds. You can save 44 seconds of your client's time by moving this whole process in post-production. Let's take a look at another scenario. Using Xphase Pro X2 to capture high-resolution HDR 360 photo for virtual tour. Here is the result from Xphase Panel Manager. It has this strange purple color cast and very high noise. Let's do a side-by-side comparison with a manual HDR. Now you see a huge improvement. The green Starbucks logo here and the blue sticker are lost in the original Xphase Panel Manager result. They all come back in the manual HDR stitch. The manual result is also very no noise. So you see the value of doing your own HDR in post-flow editing for both Theta Z1 and Xphase Pro X2 or S2. You can follow this in-depth tutorial to do exposure blending or photomatic HDR. But the problem is, those solutions are not free. Adobe Lightroom can do HDR as well, but it's also not free and it does not support 360 photo and will generate a stitch line. You are in luck for those of you who want to save money on HDR software and still want to achieve professional result. Today, I'm going to teach you SNS-HDR Lite workflow, which is free to create stunning 360 HDR photo for virtual tours. Let's dive right in. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up. No time to waste, let's go to SNS-HDR website and download the free SNS-HDR Lite command line tool. Sorry, that's Windows only. For Mac user, if you want to purchase the Pro version or get the Photomatic Pro, which tutorial is detailed right here. Go ahead and install it and go to your installation folder. For me, it's under C drive program folder. Double click on SNS-HDR.exe will show you all the settings. As you see, SNS-HDR supports 360 photo, even in the free version. Drop a thank you to the developer. Remove it aside for now and we'll come back later. Now, right click on SNS-HDR.exe and create a shortcut on your desktop. Right click on the shortcut, in the target, copy and paste this line of code after the .exe quotation mark. Bring back the window of instruction here, as you see, -pm enable 360 photo, HDR, -interior is for virtual tour. If you are shooting landscape or outdoor, use -landscape. We always want TIFF 16-bit, so -TIFF16. We use srgb as color profile. If you don't want to understand all this code, just copy my setting in the description of this video down below, hit apply and save the shortcut. Now, how to get individual HDR bracketed exposure stitch 360 photo from the brand new Xphase Pro X2 or S2? Thanks to Dean Zwicker, I totally butchered his last name, sorry Dean. He developed a plugin ORI2EEXP that will turn ORI files into individual bracketed DNG photos, as you see right here. Then, with these individual bracketed photos, I can manually merge them with SNS-HDR. I usually exclude color shift and problematic DNGs and only pick the good ones. So select all the good ones and drop it directly on top of the SNS-HDR.exe shortcut we just edited. It will just do its thing. In a couple of seconds, a beautiful 16-bit TIFF file will be generated. That is the secret why some professional can generate such a beautiful DSLR quality 360 photo with the Xphase Pro series. If this helped, give me a thumb up and drop me a thank you comment down below. For Theta Z1 is a lot easier. I will follow this Z1 with Infinity Photo tutorial to batch stitch that 9 bracketed photo out. I am assuming you do not have Adobe Lightroom here if you want to save money. Then, just drop those 9 TIFF files into the same SNS-HDR.exe files. And it will generate those beautiful HDR360 photos you saw in the intro of this video for you. If you like SNS-HDR, I do recommend purchasing their Pro version to get GUI supports, so you do not need to do the shortcut hack. But the workflow is the same. Sometimes, less option is better. Thank you for watching. I hope this helps some of you on a budget but still want to get an absolute best result of your virtual tour. For Xphase Pro series users, this workflow is kinda a must right now. You can also do this whole HDR merging thing in PTGui without using any third-party hack and command lines, but I will save it for my official Xphase Pro X2 review and tutorial videos. Don't forget to subscribe to support this channel and share with me your creative works using any knowledge you learn from this channel. Tell me how I can help more in the comment section down below, and I will see you next time.